Hello, my name is Abigail Jenner, and I will be telling you a story called The Boy Who Married the Troublesome Troll. A story from Norway, we told at the beginning of this story. Long ago, when giants and trolls still roamed the village of Norway, there was a farmer and his three sons. Wednesday morning, the farmer told his eldest son to go out and fetch some firewood. When the boy was in the forest, he picked out a tall fir tree and began to chop.
Son, a big, burly troll. Chomped out!
He was as tall as the tree and uglier than it was tall.
His nose was as
long as a broomstick, and he had one huge red eye right in the middle of his forehead. The troll grabbed the boy by the scruff of his neck and yelled, "Listen, you insignificant bag of bones, take one more swing at my tree, and that'll be the end of you. And your family too."
The troll's voice was so loud that even the snowflakes trembled, and so did the boy. But he managed to speak,
"Yes, sir. Whatever you say, sir."
The troll put him down, and the boy darted for home.
When he got home, he told the farmer he had enough of chopping wood. The next day, the second son set out to the forest. He was determined to prove himself greater than his older brother. But when he scared the racing lad,
the troll grabbed him by the scruff of his neck and yelled, "Listen, you plenty pen-sized person, take one more swing at my tree, and that'll be the end of you and your family too."
After the second son timidly answered,
"Yes, sir, whatever you say, sir," the troll put him down.
When he got home, he too vowed to never set foot in the forest again. The younger son said, "I'll go and get firewood. I'm not afraid of any troll." His two older brothers laughed.
"You? Why, you're not even big enough to get out of shape."
"That troll will chew you up and spit you out." The youngest brother paid no attention to his older brothers. It was true he wasn't big, but he had more rage than the two of them combined. He put a large round ball of cheese into his knapsack and set out for the forest. Just as he started to swing his axe,
the troll grabbed him by the scruff of his neck and yelled, "Listen, you teeny tiny troublemaker, take one more spin in my tree, and that'll be the end of you and your family too."
"Not so fast, you overgrown hunking hair," said the boy.
The troll was so startled that he dropped the boy. Quickly, he reached into his knapsack to take out the round cheese he had been saving for lunch and yelled, "If you touch one hair on my head, I'll squeeze you just the way they squeezed this rock." With that, the boy squeezed the cheese and water squirted right into the troll's one big eye. The troll fell to his knees and begged for mercy.
"Oh, please don't hurt me. I'll do anything you say."
"Very well," said the boy. "I'll spare you this time. If you promise to provide my family with all the wood we need for the rest of our lives."
"Don't worry," said the terrified troll. "You'll never be cold again."
The troll kept his promise. From then on, the wood pile by the side of the farmer's house was always neatly stacked. The sons never had to go into the forest again. Thank you for listening.